Good day, everyone. I am Abigail M. Corignote from BEd 3. What I am going to discuss to you is about the elements of fifth graders in third quarter. However, let me read the grade level standard of grade 5 first. The grade level standard of grade 5 tells that through exploration, the learner demonstrates a deeper understanding of basic knowledge and skills in music and art. Toward self-development, the celebration of Filipino cultural identity and diversity, and the expansion of one's world vision. Moving on towards our main topic, the elements of grade 5, third quarter, are lines and texture. Under the line, there is thick and thin lines. Thick lines are used to add boldness and power to a design. They are often used to add depth to an image, making things appear closer to the viewer. While thin lines are great for adding detail to an image, it's the thick line that will draw the viewer into the image. Another component under the line is straight, curved, and jagged. Straight line or classic lines provide structure to a composition. They can be oriented to the horizontal, vertical, or diagonal axis of a surface. Straight lines are by nature visually stable, while still giving direction to a composition. On the other hand, curved lines are lines that bend and change direction gradually. They can be simply wavy or spiral. Such lines convey the feelings of comfort and ease, as well as sensual quality as they remind us of the human body. Jagged lines are a series of diagonal lines joined at ends. They convey action and excitement, as well as restlessness and anxiety. Another element is texture. In the visual arts, texture is the perceived surface quality of a work of art. It is an element of two-dimensional and three-dimensional designs and is distinguished by its perceived visual and physical properties. In texture, there is ribbed, floated, woven, and carved. Moreover, the content standard for this element is that the learner demonstrates understanding of new printmaking techniques with the use of lines, texture through stories and myths, meaning learners at the end of this lesson can be able to perform artworks regarding different kinds of lines and textures. As of the performance standards, the learner creates a variety of prints using lines like thick, thin, jagged, ribbed, floated, or woven to produce visual texture. In order to do this, we can ask the students to create a painting using coffee powder. In that painting, the student should make sure that their artwork is based from myths like the sun and the moon, the children of Limokon, and etc. The facilitator's method in delivering this lesson is to teach the students how to properly draw or print lines and texture to create a more livelier and meaningful artwork. The teacher will guide the students all throughout the lesson and activities to be made. As I've said, the activity can be coffee painting. During this activity, the teacher will show his or her learners a video presentation. In that video presentation, the students will observe and listen closely because that will serve as their guidelines on how to properly create the activity. Of course, it is also relevant for the teacher to produce a procedures of this activity for the students to have a guide. These are the procedures of coffee painting. It is composed of 5 steps. The materials that will be used in this activity are watercolor paper or coupon band, palette, paintbrush, water, coffee powder in sachet, and of course, the video presentation. That's all. Thank you for listening. Remember, Stella Adler once said, "Life beats down and crushes the soul, and art reminds you that you have won."